When I'm in the studio, I'm not thinking about anything else but this one piece, I'm trying to finish this one piece and make sure it comes out correct. I first saw glass blowing in a documentary on Netflix, and I was like, that's the coolest thing ever. I want to try that. I found a studio that was near me, and the rest was history. Glass takes a while for you to like know exactly what you're doing. It's very tricky. Just like slight things can make you mess up. The slightest movements can cost you a piece. Oh man, I was terrible when I first started. Like absolutely garbage. I tried making these cups and they were just coming out super thick. It's really all about practice, and it takes a while for you to be able to get to that point where you can make pieces that like come out clean as possible. It takes a lot of practice for sure.
Alright, so this is the sandblasting area.
The process is very meditative, very zen state, you know. It helps me de-stress about a lot of things in life, you know.
I hear the bubble point.
I'm in this state where, like, oh, I gotta do this step, and the next step is this, and then I do that step, and then the next step is this. I feel like that's very helpful for people to think that way, because it just relieves a lot of stress. And it could be very stressful, but if you're doing something that you love, it's not really that stressful. It's de-stressing at the same time.
You have a sandblasted cup. Oh, I think we're good.
When I put a piece away, the feeling I get is just sigh of relief, you know? Also, like, I'm in the same state where, like, I just want to keep going. I just want to make another one just as good. But it's the complete opposite when you break a piece. It's like, breaking pieces sucks. It's the worst. You've been working on a piece for, like, 30 minutes, 45 minutes, and it just smashes on the floor, breaks into a million pieces. You're like, I just don't want to blow glass for another week. I teach at Hartwick College. I'm the TA there. I've been the TA for the past 2 years.
All right, this is the fun part.
When I teach people, it's very cool to see like their excitement and their energy and like the joy it brings to them. It's a unique material to work with, so it's like not a lot of people do it. And when someone gets the opportunity to do it and they do it right, they feel very accomplished. I feel accomplished because I just taught them what to do and I told them what to do, and it's good for both parties for sure.
Alright. So I got like a few lockers, dude, just full.
I sell most of my pieces through social media like Snapchat and Instagram mostly. I'll throw a piece on Instagram and maybe if I get a DM or two, I'll let them know it's available or something like that. Also, I have a lot of people know I already blow glass, so they come to me asking if I have anything. So I'll tell them what I have and if they're interested in anything. And also, I do commission work too, so if someone wants me to make them something, I can attempt to make it.
This one's cool. I made this one recently. It's a little, like, what, pitcher? Pour some, like, nice lemonade or sangria in or some shit.
The end goal is pretty much eventually have my own studio and sell my own pieces and be able to teach as well, like have the public come in and take lessons from me, but also have the public come in and be able to buy my pieces at the same time. With help and support, I'm sure I'll get there one day. At the end of the day, you know, I just want to keep doing what I do, enjoying glass blowing and enjoying life.